How many of you watched the congressional hearings and watched our Attorney General stammer through the definition of a lie? Okay. Our next speaker is Adryana Boyne, and she is the National Director of Voices Action, a nonprofit organization that educates and empowers Hispanics with conservative fiscal and moral values. Adriana is one of the most well-known conservatives in the Hispanic media in Texas and in the U.S. She was born and reared in Mexico. She came to the U.S. in the 1980s and became a U.S. citizen by naturalization, the right way. She is a proud American citizen. And she is going to be speaking today partially in Spanish because we have media here that can help get the message out to these communities who are being so misled and in many cases are not hearing the other side of the story. So please join me in welcoming Adriana Boyne.
Good afternoon. Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes.
I am here standing as a proud American, as a Hispanic American. I know as a Hispanic American that most Hispanics are hardworking people and are glad to be in the United States, a country that offers freedoms and opportunities not found in other countries, where people of honesty and integrity. However, the freedoms we enjoy are fragile. They can be lost if we do not take a stand to defend them. Our freedoms depend on the integrity of our government, and the integrity of our government rests on the integrity of our elections. Where there is voter fraud, this integrity is lost, and all Americans suffer from this assault in our foundational freedoms, freedoms who are based on our Constitution. Let me be clear. Voter fraud is not a partisan issue. It's not a Democratic or a Republican issue. It is not a racial issue. It is not about Hispanics or blacks or whites or Asians. It is not about social status. Whoever commits voter fraud is a criminal, whether a Democrat, a Republican, independent, white, Hispanic, black, poor or rich. They should be punished for their attack on this foundational freedom. Some deny the reality of voter fraud, calling it a scare tactic. However, it is a fact, and it should scare all Americans. In the last election, voter registration fraud happened on a large scale. We saw that in Florida. We saw it in Pennsylvania. We saw it in Wisconsin, Colorado, where the deceased are voting. Dallas County had to stop using voter registration cards as a basis for calling on jury duty because there were too many people who are not U.S. citizens who are calling for that. However, the full extent of voter registration fraud cannot be known if it takes too much effort to investigate. Where voter registration fraud prevails, voter fraud likely prevails. Without the Texas photo ID bill, voter registration is the primary defense against fraud, and it still is not a perfect defense. Unfortunately, it is very easy to get false voter registration cards. All you have to do is to write down a bogus name and you get a registration card in the mail. The Texas voter ID bill has one purpose: to limit voter fraud. It requires each person to show his or her identification with a picture and to match the name on the voter registration list. It is a simple and logical step to reduce voter fraud. So why has Attorney General Eric Holder come to Texas and voice his opinion to this bill? He says that it discriminates against some voters. This is nonsense. It is the responsibility of the Attorney General to uphold election laws that reduce fraud and corruption. And voter ID is not an unreasonable burden on legal voters. In Mexico, they require every voter to have a photo ID. In Guatemala, in all the Central American countries. And guess what? The voter identification card has greatly reduced voter fraud in Mexico. If Mexico implemented voter ID, I think the United States certainly can implement voter ID as well. Woo! If you do not have a photo ID with you right now, please raise your hand. Because if you don't have one, you can certainly go and get one for free at the Department of Public Safety.
Or for me.
This is not an unreasonable burden on legal voters. When honesty takes a second place in our hearts, we pull down everything good and noble that once surround us. We are trying to find out who is illegally engaging in voter fraud, no matter what color of ethnicity. It applies to all people, not just blacks and Latinos. We all have to show ID when we cash checks, drive a car, collect food stamps, register in a hotel, go in the airplane, buy a gun, and even when you rent a movie. Yeah. So voter ID is a common sense, no partisan solution. So why does Attorney General Eric Holder is trying to do? Is he trying to divert attention from the failures of his administration of the Department of Justice?
Yes. Yes.
Is he trying to remove the heat from the Fast and Furious scandal?
Yes.
Is he trying to campaign for President Obama?
Yes.
All these are an abuse of the public office to which he was elected. The Attorney General has the job to defend justice, not oppose it. If he cares about the integrity of our elections, he would support the Texas voter ID. Yes. Now for the Spanish media, please let me share. Estimados ciudadanos de habla hispana, la comunidad de los Estados Unidos siempre habla de honestidad y de integridad como valores importantes para su gente. Sin embargo, el procurador general o secretario de justicia, el señor Eric Holder, ha venido aquí a Texas y no le importa esta situación. ¿Será acaso que quiere distraernos de sus malos manejos en la administración de justicia? La situación de rápido y furioso que tiene que ver con las armas ilegales que penetraron a México. ¿Será acaso que quizá quiere hacer campaña para el presidente que les faltó a sus promesas a todos los hispanos? Por favor, seamos honestos. ¿Quién de ustedes no tiene una identificación con foto? ¿Quién? Quizá la use para ir a la farmacia, para ir a registrarse un hotel, para recibir estampillas de comida o quizá también para rentar una película. ¿Pero por qué no podemos tener una foto en nuestra tarjetilla de identificación? El señor Holder está tratando de intimidar a las personas de las minorías con un mensaje mal fundado. El señor Holder ha estado haciendo esta decisión porque está usando su poder para hacer campaña para un presidente que ha llevado a este país a una crisis como nunca habíamos tenido en economía y en trabajos. El fraude electoral no es algo agradable para nadie. Yo les animo, cuidadosamente, reflexionen por qué querrá venir el secretario de Justicia aquí a Texas a debatir una legislación que fue aprobada por aquellos que elegimos, aquellos que calificamos para votar. I want to end by saying that I took an oath when I became an American citizen, and proudly, this is my country, and this is my flag.